guns. Lots of guns.
What is it with you people? Why do you like John Wick so much? Why do gun dudes seem to have a major crush on John Wick? Is it some kind of weirdo violence fetish? I don't think so. I think that the reason most of us like the series is mostly the same as the reason everyone else does. John Wick 3 grossed $57 million on its opening weekend, edging out Avengers Endgame for the top spot. That's not just a bunch of steppy snecks, threepers, and moldy labias seeing this movie. The John Wick series has been defined by solid, well-paced, and relentless action on par with The Transporter and Sicario. It doesn't indulge in that lazy and infuriatingly common technique of just shaking the camera like an unwanted child to make things seem more exciting. The action is precise and clearly visible. It's not pretentious. It serves more as a vehicle for action than some thoughtful commentary on society or a showcase for compelling actors. And there's nothing wrong with that. I can tell you that real-life violence is terrifying and gut-wrenching, but most people can admit that watching pretend bad guys get their asses handed to them is a lot of fun. It's like the Kardashians. It's horrifying, but it's okay because they aren't real people. So no, gun nerds aren't fapping to John Wick as they vicariously live and kill through him. But at the same time, it's obvious that John Wick really stands out to folks like you and I. Why is that? I think the obvious answer is realism. When you watch a movie with stupid Hollywood tropes about guns, you're probably annoyed at least a little. Little things, like when guns make rattling, cocking noises every time they're pointed, might elicit an internal eye roll. And bigger things, like the diehard Glock 7 quote,
"That punk pulled a Glock 7 on me, you know what that is? It's a porcelain gun made in Germany. Doesn't show up on your airport x-ray machines here, and it costs more than you make in a month."
Could prompt wife-annoying, inappropriately loud outbursts. But the John Wick movies have a lot less than their fair share of typical Hollywood nonsense, and Keanu Reeves, Halle Berry, and others spent a great deal of time becoming actually proficient in real firearms. The director of the film, Chad Stahelski, says it perfectly.
"Best way to fake being good is just to be good, and that takes sweat, blood, and tears."
I'm sure you've seen some of the videos from Taran Tactical over the last few years. Their competency with real guns shooting live ammo shines through in their performances. This isn't the result of some pretty boy getting 10 minutes with a technical advisor telling him how to hold a gun and then claiming he received the same training as 11 Bravos. The familiarity that Reeves and Barry show with guns is second nature, and that is only possible with hours upon hours of training with real guns with live ammo on actual targets. We can see them shooting in a way that's plausible and convincing, even if it is an order of magnitude or two faster than what I can do. And the guns. Holy shit, the guns. The firearms that appear in the film are so sick. Gucci Glocks, an STI Custom 2011, and decked out Sig MPX carbines. The guns chosen for this movie are handsome, practical, and most of all, expensive. I don't think I spotted a single stock gun in the whole movie except for Winston's Browning 1903. And they get a lot of technical things really, really right. Like the stuff that bullets go through and the stuff they don't. From here on out, there are obviously going to be some spoilers. There's a scene where John Wick jumps into a pool of water with the bad guy, and I fully expected some nonsense as the camera dove underwater with him. But instead, it showed the bullets fired by the bad guy passing through just a few feet of water before curving down and dropping harmlessly to the bottom. I really think they shot footage of actual bullets fired underwater and digitally superimposed that on the blank firing gun. It looked that accurate. But they didn't get everything right. In the first few minutes of the film, John Wick is being pursued by assassins and procures an antique revolver in a museum. He attempts to load it, but the cartridge won't fit, so he quickly disassembles it and reassembles it using parts from another revolver, and then is able to load the cartridge just in time to smoke a bad guy. It's hard to see exactly what's happening, but it looks like he swaps barrel, cylinder, and hammer between the two guns, presumably because both had been damaged or intentionally deactivated in different ways. I couldn't tell if they were two of the same gun, but one appears to be a Remington 1875. He could swap the cylinder out pretty quickly, but Mr. Wick would have needed a screwdriver and several minutes, and he would have had to completely disassemble the revolver to remove and install a hammer. And I don't think he could remove the barrel without special tools at all. And then at the end of the movie, a horde of baddies assaults the Continental. John Wick knows they are coming and has time to prepare. He knows they are sent by a well-funded criminal enterprise and are consequently likely to be well-equipped. So when he selected a dope, tricked-out Sig MPX 9mm carbine and a beautiful STI 2011, I was a bit annoyed. The 9mm carbine isn't a great choice against tangos that might be wearing body armor, and the only real advantage that a PCC might have is magazine compatibility, so why choose a pistol and rifle that take different ammo? Predictably, as our intrepid anti-hero gun-foos the ever-loving shit out of the bad guys, he discovers they're entirely covered in body armor from head to toe. It's not completely inconceivable that some shadow organization could have suits like that commissioned, but the result would be very slow ninjas. Still, I'm willingly suspending my disbelief here. Except that when John Wick goes back to rearm, the concierge advises him to take a Benelli M2 and armor-piercing ammo. So this one is kind of sticky for a couple of reasons. Pistol-rated soft armor is not rated for 12-gauge. That's because part of the rating that armor receives is dependent on the degree of backface deformation, and 12-gauge drastically exceeds the 44mm allowed by the NIJ. So soft armor isn't rated for 12-gauge, and it would be no picnic to get John Wicked with a shotgun while wearing soft armor, but it would usually be survivable. The clear implication here is that the shotgun can punch right through the armor these bad guys are wearing, so is there such a thing as armor-piercing shotgun ammo? Well, yes, but not really. There have been numerous commercial products that claim to be AP, but they don't really live up to the claims. I've tested some of them here. Flechettes kind of get through soft armor, but not in any fight-stopping kind of way. By and large, the biggest factor in getting through it is velocity, and 12-gauge sabots have that in spades, relatively speaking. Hornady SST lists a 2,000 foot per second muzzle velocity. That's enough to get through virtually any pistol-rated armor without question. So we could assume that John Wick was using commercial sabot ammo intended for hunting, or possibly some specialty loads with exotic projectiles like tungsten. There are still a few technical problems with this answer, but they're beyond the scope of this video, so if you'd like to see me unpack them in another video and test for certain whether or not Hornady 12-gauge 300 grain FTX Sabo can perforate level 3A armor, leave a comment below. For now, I think it's enough to say that yes, it is possible, but just because you can doesn't mean you should. The Benelli M2 used in this movie holds 10 rounds, and it really isn't any better at defeating soft armor than a rifle in any rifle caliber. A 5.56 AR with 40 round P-Mags holds 4 times as much ammo and lets Keanu shoot a lot more baddies in a lot shorter time frame. Load it with M855A1 and it can even defeat some rifle rated plates. So while the choice would have technically worked, it was far from the best option in that room full of guns. Or, at least, it wasn't the most practical choice. But this is a movie, and it's supposed to be entertaining, and the shotgun was still a better choice as a storytelling vehicle because it changed the pace and allowed Keanu to show off those dope three-gun skills. So, why do gun dudes like John Wick? Because the technical accuracy, precision cinematography, and hard work put in by the cast results in a final product that feels like it authentically understands guns in a way that most movies don't. My opinion is entirely my own, and it's worth every cent you paid for it. This video wasn't sponsored by Lionsgate, but it was sponsored by Ventura Munitions. If you want to help us keep making content like this in the uncertain world that YouTube has become, please support our sponsors and share our videos. And because subscribing doesn't mean anything anymore, and YouTube has been suppressing the reach of our videos, you won't be notified when we publish unless you click that little bell icon. Have a great day.